चैप्टर 5 शिला हरिदास ठाकुर एंड श्री अद्वैत आचार्य। शिला हरिदास ठाकुर इज एन इटर्नल एसोसिएट ऑफ द लॉर्ड। ही अपीयर्ड इन अ यवन फैमिली इन द विलेज ऑफ बुरन विद इन द यशोहरा डिस्ट्रिक्ट। बाय हिज मर्सी मैनी पीपल रिजाइडिंग इन दैट डिस्ट्रिक्ट अटेन स्पिरिचुअल मेरिट सुकृति एंड डेवलप फेथ इन श्री कृष्ण कीर्तन। बिफोर शिला हरिदास ठाकुर अपीयर्ड there were hardly any people in that district who performed Shri Krishna Kirtan, but his appearance there dispelled this deficiency. After staying in Budan for some years, Srila Haridas Thakur moved near the bank of the Ganga. He spent time in Shantipur, where Shri Advaita Acharya resided, and also in the village named Fulia, which was not far from Shantipur. When Srila Haridas Thakur met Shri Advaita Acharya, he immediately paid obeisances to him with great faith. In response, Shri Advaita Acharya honored him with an affectionate embrace. Shri Advaita Acharya had a cave prepared for Srila Haridas Thakur's residence. It was in a secluded place on the bank of the Ganga River, very conducive for bhajan. There Shri Advaita Acharya explained to him the meaning of Srimad Bhagavatam and Bhagavad Gita in accordance with bhakti, means devotion to the Supreme Lord. Srila Haridas Thakur happily lived there and chanted Harinam. Shri Advaita Acharya daily invited Srila Haridas Thakur to his home for prasad, where they would relish narrations about Shri Krishna, Shri Krishna Katha. One day, Srila Haridas Thakur asked Srila Advaita Acharya, "O Acharya, I would like to make a request. Why do you feed me every day? Why is it that although there are so many high class and noble Brahmins in Shantipur you could feed, you instead insist on showing respect to me? Do you not hesitate to behave like this? Do you not fear the opinion of a general society? I hesitate to make any comments about this uncommon behavior of yours, but I am unable to stop myself. My humble request is that you please act in such a way that society will not disrespect or even have an opportunity to criticize you." Acharya kahena tumi na kariya bhai, sei acharibe jai shastra mat hai, tumi khaile hai khoti brahman bhojan, eta vali shraddh patr karayala bhojan. श्री चैतन्य चैतामृत अंत लीला 3.221 एंड 222। हेयरिंग श्रील हरिदास ठाकुर वर्ड्स द टीचर ऑफ द मासेस जगत गुरु श्री अद्वैत आचार्य रिमेंबर द इम्पार्शल वर्ड्स ऑफ द स्क्रिप्चर्स रिलेटेड टू द सुप्रीम ट्रूथ। लाफिंगली ही सेड, देयर इज नो नीड टू बी अफ्रेड, आई विल ओनली एक्ट इन अ वे दैट इज रिकमेंडेड बाय द रिवील्ड स्क्रिप्चर्स। Feeding you is equivalent to feeding tens of millions of Brahmins. Shri Advaita Acharya then offered the Shraddh Patra, or offerings of oblations to the forefathers, to Shri Haridas Thakur. Having obtained the association of such a like-minded, affectionate pure devotee possessing a deep taste for Harinam as Shri Haridas Thakur, the happiness of Shri Advaita Acharya knew no bounds. Out of love, Shri Advaita Acharya roared loudly. Overwhelmed in such great happiness, he expressed himself and Shri Advaita Acharya in the outburst of joy. By the influence of the association of his Ishtadev, his worshipable Lord Shri Advaita Acharya, Srila Haridas Thakur also became submerged in the nectarious ocean waves of Shri Govind Ras. Footnote: Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur has mentioned in his Gaudiya Bhashya of Shri Chaitanya Bhagavat, Adi Khand 16.21. Many people hold the notion that Srila Haridas Thakur kept himself busy only in chanting the holy name, and that he had no entry into relishing the nectarian mellows, rasa of Shri Govinda. However, this belief of the Prakrit Sahajyas, who understand the transcendental pastimes of the Supreme Lord to be mundane, is completely erroneous. Shri Naam is Chintamani, a transcendental wish-fulfilling gem, and is Shri Krishna himself, the personification of rasa. One cannot taste the rasa of Shri Krishna by any process other than chanting Shri Naam. Srila Haridas Thakur, who is completely conversant with the rasa of Shri Krishna Naam, is the principal teacher granting entrance into the scriptures dealing with rasa. Because of the offenses committing to Naam, the sentimental Prakrit Sahajiya's community, which is utterly engrossed in materiality, has no idea about the transcendental nectar of Naam. Their desire for Sriman Mahaprabhu's descent. Chanting the holy name, Srila Haridas Thakur stayed in a solitary place near the banks of the Janavi River Ganga in a cave. The meeting of Sri Advaitacharya and Srila Haridas Thakur was like the joining of a gem with gold. It seemed as if these personalities, like the supremely purifying Yamuna and Ganga, had appeared to remove the filth of this world. Their goal was one and the same, to cause the descent of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, who is not different from Brajendra Nandan, so that he may deliver the decrepit souls who have turned their faces away from Hari and are thus suffering the threefold miseries. While the most merciful Sri Advaitacharya was absorbed in worshipping Sri Vishnu by offering him Ganga water and tulsi leaves, Srila Haridas Thakur was engrossed in loudly performing Naam Sankirtan in his cave. Dui janer bhakte chaitanye kaila avatar, Naam prem prachar kaila jagat udhar. Sri Chaitanya Chaitamrit, Antilila 3.224. It was due to the devotion, the call of Sri Advaitacharya and Srila Haridas Thakur, that Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu descended and delivered the entire world by preaching Naam Prem. While roaming along the banks of Ganga, Srila Haridas Thakur would loudly cry out in ecstasy, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. He was completely detached from all material pleasures, and his lotus mouth was supremely blessed, being always filled with Krishna Naam. He never, even for a moment, stopped chanting Krishna Naam, and because he was submerged in bhakti ras at every moment, many varieties of ecstatic symptoms would appear on his transcendental body. Sometimes he danced, and sometimes he roared loudly like a mad lion. Sometimes he cried bitterly, sometimes he laughed loudly, and sometimes he fell down unconscious. In 1 second, he would call out to someone with divine words, and in the very next second, he would beautifully explain the meaning of those words. As soon as he would begin to dance in Naam Sankirtan, all the ecstatic symptoms that appear as a result of extremely loving devotion, prema bhakti, such as the shedding of tears, the hairs of the body standing on end, laughter, the loss of consciousness and perspiration, would enter his body. His performance of kirtan was laden with love, and Srila Haridas Thakur's lotus limbs became completely drenched in the tears of ecstasy flowing from his eyes. Even complete atheists, devoid of bhakti, became astonished to see Srila Haridas Thakur in such a state. Even Lord Brahma and Lord Shiva became struck with wonder upon seeing such ecstatic transformations in his divine body. Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Prabhupada has stated in his Gaudiya Bhashya on Sri Chaitanya Bhagavat, Adi Khand 16.22-32. Srila Haridas Thakur's state was just like that mentioned in Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu 1.3.25-26 and Srimad Bhagavatam 11.2.40. Khantir Avyarth Kalatvam Viraktir Man Shunyata Asha Bandha Samutkantaha नाम गाने सदा रुचि ही, असक्तिस्तद गुणाख्याने प्रीतिस्तद वसुति स्थले इति आद्य अनुभाव श्योर जात भाव अनुकर जने। When भाव pure spiritual emotion arises, the following 9 symptoms are observed in a devotee: forbearance, effective use of one's time, detachment, absence of pride, steadfast hope that Krishna will bestow his mercy, intense longing to obtain one's goal, constant taste for chanting the holy name, attachment to hearing about Krishna's qualities, and affection for Krishna's pastime places. एवं व्रत स्वप्रिय नाम कीर्तया जात अनुराग धृत चित्त उच्चहि हसति अथो रोदति रोति गायति उन्माद वा नृत्यन्ति लोक भागे। इन द हार्ट ऑफ द डिवोटीज हु हैव अडॉप्टेड द वॉ टू सर्व भगवान थ्रू भक्ति योग करेक्टराइज बाय प्योर लव डीप अटैचमेंट अराइजेस फॉर द चैंटिंग ऑफ द नेम्स ऑफ देयर मोस्ट बिलवड लॉर्ड एंड देयर हार्ट मेल्ट्स Being indifferent to public opinion, they sometimes burst into laughter, sometimes weep, sometimes call out to the Lord in a loud voice, sometimes sing, and sometimes dance as if mad. While he manifested such symptom of love, Srila Haridas Thakur's tongue remained busy in constantly chanting Krishna Nam. Due to incessantly uttering Sri Nam, his tongue was extraordinarily beautiful. Both Srila Haridas Thakur and his tongue were thoroughly indifferent to material pleasures. Krishna Nam never dances on the tongue of materially engrossed people. Those who are always busy tasting the 6 different types of delicious foods and whose heart is agitated and forced to dart here and there, being greedy for and expectant of material pleasures, are never seen to have any interest in chanting Krishna Nam. As the materialists remain indifferent to Harinam Bhajan, so too the pseudo renouncers who do not accept Sri Krishna Nam. Due to his complete absorption in Nam Bhajan, Srila Haridas Thakur was utterly indifferent to material pleasures. This was his preeminence. Srila Haridas Thakur left no room for indifference or laziness while chanting Govinda's names. He, in a multitude of ways, was at every second absorbed in the mellows of devotional service to Sri Krishna, Krishna Bhakti Ras. Srila Haridas Thakur's transcendental body was not like the bodies of materialists, which are made of blood, flesh and skin. Many different ecstatic symptoms, Shuddha Sattvic Bhavs, would appear in his divine body as a result of his constant service to Sri Nam Prabhu. Materialists remain indifferent to cultivation of service to Sri Krishna, Krishna Anushilan, while they keep themselves focused on the health of their bodies. In complete contrast to this, the Vaishnava associates of the Lord, who are inclined to perform service to Him, always have the multitude of pure ecstatic body transformations, sattvic bhavs, wildly dancing throughout their body.